Welcome, Cav fans, to week 14, so to speak, on Coach's Corner here in Mike Spriggs' basement. And so I'd like to recap the season and recap last week's game a little bit, and then have a little shout-out to our seniors and also some throw out some thank yous to lots of people for all their support of Cav football. So let's go back to last week, our regional finals game, the final eight, I guess, trying to get to that final four. Versus Marion, and obviously didn't go the way we liked it or wanted it to, and really more than anything, we played a really good football team, a well coached team that took it to us, and certainly that you never know how it's going to go, but when you give up a touchdown on the very first play, the tone kind of got set, and we never really could recover and get really, really back into the game. The defense really played pretty well the first half. We did make some plays offensively, but could never string any several plays or several first downs together. And certainly then we made some mistakes. Uncharacteristically, we lost the kicking game. We had a snap over the punter's head. We'd give up a 98-yard touchdown. So those things just catch up with you when you play a really good football team. And their physicalness on offense, kind of wore us out, and that's a good team we played. That's a really, really good team we played. So congrats to Marion Local, and as they move on to the Final Four, a lot to be proud of with this team. This senior group, 9-4 on the season, 9-4 over their 4 years. They were part of two state titles and one state runner-up, a couple league titles. Again, 9-4 this year, and then a lot of tough ball games. And I think over the course of a season that kind of wears you down, and especially when a lot of our guys were playing both ways, did not have a lot of great depth, so that didn't help. But we got 9 wins, and we finished second in the league and by ourselves, and feel pretty good about that, although the expectation is, as you know, you want to win that league title. Looking back, at least for a few days here, feel pretty good about the senior class. 12 of them our slogan this year was protect the shield, and for the most part, those guys really protected the shield. So hopefully, the younger guys can learn from those guys and grow up a little bit, some of them, and hopefully move forward into next season and really starting this winter and the spring, and then move into next season. So. A real quick recap of those seniors, and I don't want to miss anybody, so I might peek down a few times. But 12 seniors. Number 3, Jack Mullenkamp, was a corner for us, really good corner, second team all-league. Sam Broering was our quarterback, played a little bit of defense early, but mainly was our quarterback. And again, Sam was one of our good leaders, and proud of Sam and the way he played. Jacob Hardings, number 11, was an outside backer and inside receiver, and really, played really, really well at the end of the season. Got better and better and better as the season went on, both offensively and defensively. Number 19, Tyler Bax, is a great, great program guy. He was on the special teams, and really proud of the way Tyler handled the whole season, and really was just a huge part of our, just being a Cavalier and protecting that shield. Number 24, Brad Gear, was an inside linebacker and fullback. And again, one of our guys that probably worked harder than maybe anybody on our whole team to get ready for the season, and real proud of the way Brad played. Seth Obringer, number 36, one of our inside linebackers and fullback and special teams guy. So good scrappy dude that, he'll go into wrestling and do a good job there. Number 45, Caleb Dippold. Caleb, very much like Jacob Hardings, an outside linebacker and inside receiver. Did a really good job all year, played the whole season, got set back with a concussion early, but came back and played really well, and had a good game the other night with on several tackles. Number 53, Derek Albers, was a full-time starter offensively and defensively, I wish we had more depth where he could have got off the field some, but was our left tackle on offense, defensive end, and gosh, played almost every play offensively and defensively all year, so great job by Derek. Number 54, Jason Wenning, was one of our defensive tackles, and ended up playing offensive line for us the last couple games. Did a good job. And like always, we have one defensive tackle typically that's a quick guy, that quick and strong. And so Jason did a good job for us. number 71 or 99, Creighton Bettinger, was a defensive end for us and a special teams guy, mainly a defensive end. And again, undersized defensive end like we always have, but really quick and runs to the ball and made several tackles for loss and some sacks. And so Creighton was our defensive end for us. Number 75, Big Thomas Sweeterman, had a great season, both offensively and defensively. First team all league on offense and second team on defense, and just was a big, strong, physical guy that the other team had to be aware of, especially on defense, and made lots and lots of tackles and tackles for loss. Really good season. And then number 77, Cody Hart, Thomas's sidekick, I guess, our other big daddy. And he played offensive line and a little bit of defensive line. Unfortunately for Cody, he was really, really hampered with a sprained ankle most of the season, unfortunately for him. But really did a good job on on offense with his blocking and a great attitude. And so really appreciate Cody's effort. So 12 seniors. We're going to miss those guys. Really, really good, solid guys that came to practice every day and did what we asked them to do. And gave great effort on Friday nights, and like we said, there were a lot of Friday nights that were tight, down to the wire games, and we won several of those. So, you know, as they think about their season, I'm sure they're probably a little disappointed right now, but down the road, hopefully, when they see the highlight tape and hanging out with their buddies, they should feel good about their season and how they handled themselves. And you know, I always think about this in high school athletics. You always lose your last game unless you're the state champ. And I guess the exception would be if you don't make the playoffs and you win your 10th game. But in every other sport, you always end your season with a loss. So that kind of stinks, you know, to think about your last game that typically it's a loss. And so they're stinging from that, and we all sting from that. And so it was a frustrating loss for us last week, but it's time to move forward. You get over it, you move forward, and you take the positives and find out and look for the weaknesses and figure out what we can do better next year. So before I close, some thank yous, I guess. Really, thank you to all you people who watch and really the whole, I guess, Cav Nation, so to speak, all the supporters of Coldwater Athletics and football. And I feel really fortunate to be living in Coldwater and coaching here and love teaching there and love coaching and love going to practice and really enjoy it. And so many people to thank for that. Just the support that we get from the parents, from the community and school and all those people that really enjoy athletics in Coldwater. And then also all the support staff that really help make my job easier and really make coaching here a fun thing with Eric Goodwin and his staff and Chris and all the stats guys and Mike doing all this film work for us and our other film guys, Rob and Rob Schmidt and Mr. Kramer, drawing a blank on his first name. Scott Kramer doing our film and just taking time out to come and film our guys, the cheerleaders, Merle who drives our bus along with Scott and Smitty. There's so many people. Tiff, our trainer. There's so many people that are involved in the program. And I'm sure I missed some there, so I apologize. excuse me. So many people that get involved and help us, Mitch Voskel and his whole staff. Just whatever we need done gets taken care of in a great way, in a class way. So really appreciate all those people that help take care of us and take care of our players, especially take care of our players. And so proud of this squad, proud of this team. Again, we finished 9-4 on the season and looking forward to next year and taking on that challenge of regrouping and see if we can better that 9-4 record, I guess, and try to maintain that playoff streak and try to win a league championship next year. So thanks for your support. Until next year.